747-FREE. This is ESPN 106.3 WUUB Jupiter, a Good Karma Brands radio station. Here's a message from Ken LaVica.
Hope you're ready for a face full of hip drop tackle talk. Stone Labanowitz hit the open.
Just like you would expect, the fire hose is fully inserted in my mouth here, and we've been blowing and going, and so...
Ken LaVica.
Get a run in, make an early cocktail, cut a gummy in half.
Theo Dorsey.
Very excited to have the opportunity to add him to the team.
Stone Labanowitz.
When I woke up this morning, I was feeling pretty dangerous.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios.
It doesn't matter what your name is!
It's LaVica, Theo, and Stone, presented by Hard Rock Bet. Florida's official sports book on ESPN 106.3.
I tell you, Theo, this cancel culture has gotten out of control. Let's talk about some famous bands in sports.
There we go.
Famous bands. Pete Rose, banned from baseball.
Yeah, yep.
Marge Schott, former Reds owner, got a little too allegedly Nazi-ish. Banned. Who else has been banned? What are some other notable sports bans here? That guy from the Raptors is probably about to get banned.
He's cooked.
Porter. We'll get to him in a second, by the way. Hey, pro athletes, if you're going to gamble on sports, if you're going to gamble on sports, you should probably make it a little less noticeable that you're gambling on sports, okay? The Temple basketball team. They're probably about to get banned.
Tough.
A little point shaving action.
Who's that baseball coach? College baseball? Was it Alabama?
He's banned. He's definitely banned.
Calvin Ridley got banned for a year.
Calvin Ridley did get banished for a year. Yeah. So, hey, in sports, we ban things. If we don't like it, we say, get out of here. We ban things. And the latest ban is the hip drop tackle. The hip drop tackle that out for a couple of years, and we've heard that it might get banned. Well, this is what happens on March 26th. In a week where you're outside of the NCAA tournament games, it's another 48 hours until we have another tip-off in, am I allowed to say this, March Madness?
Sorry.
In college basketball's postseason tourney.
I think the big dance goes.
I don't know. I don't even know of that.
Yeah.
But this is what happens this time of year. We latch onto something, and in the sports talk realm, we just beat you to death with it. We just beat you over the skull over and over and over again. And that one singular topic in this time of year where we don't have college basketball to speak of, where we're in the NFL offseason, where free agency is tapered down, and we're still a couple of weeks from the draft. We're a week and a half away from the Masters. Baseball hasn't started yet. You know what we do on a day like today? We beat you over your head with a topic like the hip drop tackle. And may I introduce all of you to a hip drop tackle Tuesday. Woo! Here on LaVica, Theo, and Stone. Stone, the celebratory and identifying sound effect for today, please.
Yeah.
Hold on. That's tackle. There it is. Hip drop tackle Tuesday here on LaVica, Theo, and Stone. You want to hear that one more time? Because it's very aggressive, by the way, the tackling. It almost doesn't sound like tackling.
Yeah.
It sounds like passion. Yeah. Let's just hear that one more time. It's actually better the second time around.
It is better the second time. It sounds more like a scrum.
It does sound like a scrum, again, or something else. You know what? It's kind of satisfying.
Yeah.
One more time. Hip drop tackle Tuesday.
That's a hip bone.
Or a humerus.
Yeah.
Just when you thought you had enough hip drop tackle talk,
mm-hmm.
we hit you at noon with more.
That's right. I hope you're prepared for more hip drop tackle
talk. Y'all are forgetting a pivotal word.
What's that?
A swivel.
How can you forget the swivel and the hip drop tackle?
It's just not as catchy.
No, it isn't.
It's harder to say. It's a swivel hip drop tackle.
If you listen to one,
put that in there.
That's fine. Whatever. Unsportsmanlike. With Evan Cohen, Chris Canty, Michelle Smallman. First take. Get up.
Greeny showed up to work today.
Greeny show our lead in. They've all talked extensively about the hip drop tackle with a swivel on top.
Yes.
Theo, can you define a hip drop tackle?
A hip drop tackle.
No, all not right. A hip hop tackle.
A hip drop tackle. That's when Flavor Flav runs up from behind you.
Could you imagine if Flavor Flav tried to tackle anybody?
Why was Flavor Flav the first hip hop guy I thought of?
That is really bizarre, actually.
I can't.
On a day like today, there are plenty of other options.
Flavor Flav just attached to your back, trying to drag you to the ground, and all you have to do is just like flick him off.
Yeah. Is that how they got Diddy out of the mansion? Hip hop, hip drop tackle?
Low hanging fruit there.
That's
a Diddy
different
joke.
That's a different thing that's driven Diddy from his mansion and to a foreign country.
I have
allegedly
like four P. Diddy jokes lined up for today that I was going to sprinkle.
Oh man, did I jump the gun on the Diddy jokes?
It's fine. Add it to the list.
Okay. All right. Good. Okay. All right. I'll leave Meek Mill out of this one.
Yeah.
Let's just go straight into the hip drop tackle. What is it? What is it? What does it look like? Right. So you're behind the guy, right? And then you grab him, right? And you want to take him down. He's running forward. You're running behind him.
Uh-huh.
And then you wrap around him and then you just drop all your weight. And then maybe you swivel to the left, swivel to the right, and you collapse on them and make their weight fall on themselves. Right. I think that's the hip drop tackle.
I actually think that's a pretty good explanation there.
Wasn't bad from a guy that doesn't do a lot of tackling.
Now, let me read to you from ESPN.
It shows.
Let me read to you from ESPN.
When's the last time you tackled?
The new ban.
I'm sorry, you did throw a lot of interceptions.
Of the hip drop tackle topped with a swivel. Here we go. From ESPN, NFL owners have approved a rule proposal to ban the swivel hip drop tackle. The league announced on Monday the violation will result in a 15-yard penalty if flagged in games. But Troy Vinson, the NFL's executive vice president of football operations, strongly implied last week that it's likely to be enforced similarly to the use of helmet rule, which typically leads to warning letters and fines in the week after a game rather than flags during play. Interesting little twist there.
I like it.
The hip drop tackling ban proposal was written to address only a subset of the rugby tackling style that has spread around the NFL in recent years. Competition Committee Chairman Rich McKay said last week, the tackling technique often results in lower body injuries. The rule requires officials to note two actions, Theo. If a defender grabs the runner with both hands or wraps the runner with both arms and also unweights himself by swiveling and dropping his hips and or lower body, landing on and trapping the runner's leg or legs at or below the knee. On Monday, McKay clarified that Monday's rule change doesn't eliminate the hip drop tackle, only the, quote, swivel technique that doesn't get used very often.
Yeah. Can't swivel, man.
You can't swivel.
What are we doing?
We can't even determine with technology where a ball should be placed after a play in the NFL. We rely on old man eyes and guys with chains on the sideline who are about 60 years of age and above to determine where the ball should be, deciding games. We continually watch officials call things that are pass interference that aren't pass interference, or hits on quarterbacks, they shouldn't be penalties, mere pokes to the shoulder that send flags airborne and 15 yards given to the offense. When you look at the replay over and over again, you say, how in God's name was that a penalty? We have officials who look at replays. It's clear as day what should be called or not called, and the officials get that wrong after video review. How could this be a problem? Surely the officials will always be able to determine in real time. Hip drop tackle, but was there a swivel? I don't know. What could go wrong, guys? What could go wrong with banning the hip drop tackle with a swivel on top? Surely it'll be easy to adjudicate. No problem.
I just can't wait until they start bringing that telestrator out, right?
And you'll
going
see
over
here,
the replay in slow motion.
He moved his right arm, and he took his pectoral back, and that right there seems like the slightest bit of swivel. Yeah. That should have been a flag.
What is that?
That was just a weird old-timey broadcaster. I don't know why I brought that out, actually.
It's like the 40s.
Dean
that was really bizarre. Like, look, see, here's the tailback, and he ran around a right guard. And I don't know why I was doing that, actually.
And none of them sound like that.
No, not at all. So, in conclusion, this is not going to be officiated well. We are at a point in the sport of football where the offense has so much advantage that you might as well just take the defense off the field.
Yeah.
J.J. Watt said yesterday, he tweeted, we might as well just start putting flags on the players. Sort of agree with that. Here's RG3. RG3 not happy. RG3 incensed, in fact.
Oh,
this was on Get Up. This is RG3, Robert Griffin III. He has had it with the NFL and their pesky hip drop tackle focus.
Molly, I don't agree with it. I understand what the NFL is trying to do by making the game safer, but what they're really doing is making it unsafe for defenders. When you think of this, like, how is a guy supposed to tackle an offensive guy from behind now? You got defenders that linebackers, DBs, safeties that are going to be going up against guys that are 30, 40, 50 pounds heavier than they are. And the only way for them to get them down to the ground is to try to use their own body weight as leverage to get them there. I want the game to be safer. I have a guy that was hip drop, molly whop, and spun on my top in my NFL career. So I understand how they're trying to take unnecessary injuries and unnecessary plays out of the game. But at the same time, I still want the guys to be able to go out there and play the game of football. And right now, this is only going to add more penalties to the game. It's only going to add more flags and more fines. And I don't think that's what people want to see. We want the game to be safe, but it's got to be an even playing field for both sides of the ball.
All right. So RG3 weighed in. We've weighed in.
Hip drop, molly whopped, and spun on my top.
How long do you think it took him to workshop that, by the way?
He was in the mirror.
I think he came off the top.
No way.
He doesn't come off the top with anything. It's all contrived. He calculates it up. He writes it down. He practices it in his mirror.
You guys are disrespecting Robert Griffin III if you think that he practiced hip drop, molly whopped, and spun on my top.
No, he definitely.
I think he did.
Ken definitely does it every single day.
Yeah,
on
that's
this show.
Ken LaVica.
Yeah.
Now you're underestimating.
Now you're disrespecting me.
Disrespecting this guy.
Why? Because he doesn't prepare any of it. It all comes
off the top. But he's good off the top. I think
off
RG3.
My top. On my top. Sorry.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Off the top.
Off the top.
He's usually good off the top.
Yeah. And molly whopped.
But RG3, you know he's writing this stuff down. He's got a little notebook he probably carries around
with him. And then he says it over and over again.
You know, I do have a problem, though, with players. And we'll get into this. I have a problem who aren't currently playing having, you know, a take on this. Like, I want to hear from the guys inside the locker room. Well, I truly do.
We said yesterday we were going to try and get Javon Curse. How are we doing on that, Theo?
Pierre Garçon.
Oh, you're going to put it on Pierre Garçon. So let me guess what's about to happen.
Good God.
No, we don't have Javon Curse, and Theo's about to blame Pierre Garçon, the intermediary between him and Javon Curse.
Could have gone with no.
Pierre says,
he
said, he's down. What's the call-in number? And I said, well, Pierre, tell him to send us his number. We'll call him, but I also gave the call-in number. So maybe at any point, if you see something that pops up on
Javon
the phone lines.
All right, if Javon Curse calls, Stone, put him through.
Yeah.
I don't care if we're not talking about a hip drop tackle.
Yeah, we'll bring it up.
Because you want to know why we'll just take Javon Curse to talk about hip drop tackles? Because, Stone, it is a hip drop tackle Tuesday. There it is. Sexy tackle. Broken hip. There it is.
Oh.
The hip drop tackle is banned. The swivel hip drop tackle is banned. Banned. Because it's March 26th, I'm not going to fall into the sports talk radio trap, though. We are not doing 45 minutes
Hell
on the hip drop
no.
tackle. We are not doing that. Well, I don't know why. Because that sucks. It bores me to tears. I want no part of that. You got enough of that with Greeny and Hembo. You got enough of that with Chris Canty, who couldn't bother to reach back out to us after Theo tried to book him for the show. How are we doing on Chris Canty?
Chris Canty has not responded.
Okay, there we go. So you heard enough from Chris Canty. We've heard enough from RG3.
Yeah.
Hip hop on my top molly whop or whatever he said. I have no idea. So for me, let's talk about things that need to be banned, like the hip drop tackle. In lieu of breaking down the hip drop tackle, why don't we also add, in a world of cancel culture, things in sports that need to be added to the ban list? And may I direct you to a tweet that I saw this morning, because it's always football season, guys. It is always football season, always time to prepare for, think about football season. I mean, hell, we started talking about the hip drop tackle today. So I'm scrolling through Twitter, and the Pro Football Hall of Fame Twitter account tweeted the following this morning. The Chicago Bears will face the Houston Texans in Canton for the 2024 Hall of Fame game, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, Thursday, August 1st. That's exciting, right? That's exciting.
Hell yeah.
Tickets on sale, 10 a.m., Friday, April 12th. I thought to myself, you know what? Why the hell is anybody paying money to go see a preseason game? Why would you, as smart, consuming, fiscally responsible Americans, sit down and say, you know what? Hell, I'll pay $50 to go see three snaps for C.J. Stroud. I'll go and presumably see two throws from Caleb Williams. $50, NFL, billion-dollar industry, take my money. You know what I say to that? Ban having to pay for tickets for NFL preseason games. A lot of teams include them in a season ticket package. Some people buy them standalone. You know what I say? Preseason games should be free. You shouldn't have to pay money to see third stringers battle it out for spot number 58 on the roster. Not this guy. I ain't doing it. And I challenge you to join my fight against paying money to see NFL preseason games. I've attended plenty in my life. You want to know what? They suck. Ooh. All of them. Even that vaunted third preseason game where the starters play a quarter. No. Enough. Make them free. Ban paying money for NFL preseason games. I say that's the next thing in sports that needs to be banned, along with the swivel hip drop tackle. What else in sports needs to be banned? 888-760-3776. 888-760-3776. Social media at KLV1063. That's 888-760-3776. And social media open at KLV1063. Theo, I sense that Stone wants to disagree with me about paying for NFL preseason football, because I look across the way and he appears to be twitchy and have something that's about to come out of his mouth. What do you want?
That's very accurate. So you're setting a dangerous precedent. You want a bunch of scumbags to fill the stadium?
How is it different for any other NFL game? Have you seen these morons who put this face paint on and they chug beers and they fight one another and then they fall down and vomit all over the place in concourses? There's scumbags who pay big money to go to NFL games. How is this any different?
They paid for those rights.
What?
They earned the ability to paint their faces and chug and do and eat and all of that stuff. Now, if you just open the floodgates, who knows who's coming through that gate?
Fans.
Yeah.
Not
like
the fans,
families.
Not the fans you're looking
no.
for.
What? Just because it's free, you assume that the people are going to be bad?
Right.
There's bad people in the stadiums. Didn't some Dolphins fans kill people last year?
Okay, first of all,
they did,
I think
you're
twisting that a little bit. There was a fight in the stands, and the guy had a heart attack because he picked a fight with the Dolphins fan,
allegedly. A guy died
in the stands. People die in the stands at NFL games.
Yeah.
People fight in the parking lots.
If it weren't for the fight, Theo, he'd probably be alive.
Right.
Okay.
The fight might have induced that heart attack.
He could have been walking down the stairs later that night and had his heart issue befall him, too. Let's not go crazy.
Are you taking a shot at Dolphins fans there?
Not taking a shot at Dolphins fans. I don't talk about the Chiefs fans either. I know it was probably going to get there. That happened at home. So I don't know.
All I'm saying is that football fans are largely a dumb species. Because let's not forget, people paid hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars in Kansas City to go and then lose multiple digits via frostbite in January.
Yeah. And leave their friends outside to die.
Exactly.
That was different. That was at home.
Allegedly. Let's make sure. We don't want any lawsuits. This is a litigious society.
And the bank robber guy, he thought he had a mask, but he thought he was cool.
It can't be free.
NFL fans are dopey meatballs, me included. And so it doesn't matter if they're paying to be dopey meatballs or for free showing up to be dopey meatballs. They're going to be dopey meatballs. Yeah. Just because you paid to get into something doesn't mean that you're going to abandon all your meatball sensibilities. So what I say is stop paying. Stop paying for NFL preseason games. Pro Football Hall of Fame, you ain't taking my money.
See,
stop taking people's money. NFL organizations, stop taking people's money in the preseason. These games are all universally terrible. If I want to see amateurs play football, I'll go to a high school football game. Okay, I don't need to go
amateurs.
To preseason game number two to see a guy who came out of Idaho State and is hoping to make one tackle with his stupid neck roll.
How about a guy that came out of FAU?
Yeah.
Mr. Pickle in Iowa State?
Idaho State would be like... Is there an Idaho State?
Idaho State's
don't
not good.
Don't say what you're about to say.
No, Idaho would probably be... No, I'll
say the Vandals,
around.
Right?
The Vandals. FAU would be favored by a field goal versus Idaho if they
played
tomorrow.
Shut up.
I knew he was coming with the heat.
Shut up.
Idaho would be...
Tom Herman right now and tell that to him.
I would tell it to his face. FAU would be favored by a field goal over the Idaho Vandals. So
watch
your mouth over there.
I can't wait to have Tom Herman on next week.
I'll tell it to his face.
Wait.
It over the phone.
With the Pro Football Hall of Fame stuff, I'm not going to have you talking too much down on them. The Pro Football Hall of Fame just trying to make some money. Also, I just realized.
Didn't he just go there recently or
they're
something?
Fine.
No, their Twitter account follows me. So I don't know if that makes
Who
me
cares?
A Hall of Famer, but I'm going to support and back the Pro Football,
the Pro Football Hall,
Hall
of Fame.
Pay
no.
your money.
No.
Get in the game.
No.
Pay your money. Can't stop
no.
trying to be a lousy cheapo.
No.
Pay the money and go support the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
You have so many people come through your turnstiles every year. Stop making people pay for NFL preseason action because it's universally terrible. You're seeing starters play two plays.
No.
I don't care to see spend $70 to see C.J. Stroud play four snaps or Caleb Williams throw two passes. Enough already.
What
stop.
It's all about.
NFL, stop making people pay for preseason games. Stop making people pay for tickets to preseason games. It's a racket and it's anti-American. What else should be banned in sports outside of the hip drop tackle and paying for preseason games? 888-760-3776. 888-760-3776. That's 888-760-3776. And social media at KLV1063. You're also watching us on YouTube. You can see us in glorious color in motion picture on YouTube right now. What else are you banning in sports, Theo? What are you banning? What are you nixing?
This is an easy one for me, and I thought about it over this these NFL owner meetings. I want to ban asking former college coaches about their college quarterbacks, especially during draft season.
Are you talking about Jim Harbaugh?
I gotta bring up Jim Harbaugh here. Now,
what did he say
examples.
About J.J. McCarthy?
There's a few examples, but let's go right to the audio from the NFL owners meetings in Orlando when he was professing the greatness of J.J. McCarthy from his pro day.
The workout J.J. had, I've been to a lot of pro day workouts and watch quarterbacks throw. That was the best I've ever seen a quarterback do at a pro day. I mean, not only was feet great and the individual drills, and but then he started throwing and it was like every throw was right there. I thought our receivers did a great job too.
Everybody
had a great day. But that was the best throwing day I've ever seen. And then your coaches and GMs, come up to me and say, great job with JJ. And, we, like I predicted, once they were around him, I was hearing the stories about how he is on the board, how he is,
All right.
Everybody's great.
So Jim Harbaugh.
I'm great.
In case you didn't quite catch all of that.
JJ's great.
It was a loud room. His feet were great.
The receivers are great.
Jim Harbaugh says JJ McCarthy's feet are great. The receivers were great.
Everybody's great.
He got congratulated.
He recruited.
Yeah. Jim Harbaugh says he got congratulated by GMs for JJ McCarthy. He said it was the best throwing day he's ever seen. Keep in mind, Jim Harbaugh was the college coach of Andrew Luck.
Yeah.
You can't tell me that J.J. McCarthy had a better pro day with better feet And better throwing days, and even better receivers.
Yeah, better. Everything's better.
and
he got better than this guy.
He got congratulated about JJ McCarthy on his pro day, and not Andrew Luck. Okay.
He's not the only one. And that's why I didn't want to single it out to just Jim Harbaugh, because we know how he can be. And of course, he plays into all of that stuff. And they just won the national championship. Kudos to you.
So you're saying that you no longer want all coaches should come draft time. All college coaches should no longer be allowed to analyze and break down their then former quarterback going to the draft.
Here's another coach who made a very profound prediction. I want you to tap into this one.
Can I guess who it is?
Okay, you can guess.
Because I actually don't know.
Okay.
But I bet, just based on my memory, is this Dabo?
It's going to be Dob. It's going to be the Dobster, Dabo Sweeney.
Is this Superman Deshaun Watson?
Do we have it? Okay, we
Stone's panicking. Don't worry, Stone.
We may not have. Did my mic just get cut?
No.
Okay, I can't hear myself anymore. Oh, there I go. Do we have it? It should be on the sheet. If not, I think we all remember the quote.
Yeah. He called him Superman.
It wasn't just Superman. Dabo Sweeney, at that time, here goes Stone, compare it. Deshaun Watson to maybe somebody almost as perfect as Superman in the world of sports.
Same guy every day and always ready. Comes to every meeting prepared. He's just...
And every
that's how you change sessions. You know, you change a culture through... For me, it's through discipline and recruiting and staffing and all that stuff. You know, for them, it's...
Jesus.
It's decision-making. It's who you pick. And,
Jesus was always prepared.
They pass on Deshaun Watson. They're passing on Michael Jordan. I mean,
if they pass on Deshaun Watson,
they pass on.
And you know what's funny? The Michael ironic Jordan. Part. You know what team he was talking about passing on Deshaun Watson? The Cleveland Browns, because they had the number one overall pick, Hugh Jackson, back then. So at least they got Michael Jordan now.
Just telling you. They pass on Deshaun Watson. They're passing on Michael Jordan.
I mean, Deshaun Watson's been good, but then
not for the Browns.
A scumbag, and now he's bad with the Browns.
Yeah.
Unless you're talking about like overall career income. Now we're starting to hit a potential comparison.
He might have passed Michael Jordan with career.
I mean, Deshaun
income.
Watson, not as marketable.
Yeah.
Now, as Michael Jordan was in his prime.
Not quite.
Uh-uh.
How many championships have you had to go ring for ring, Jordan, Watson? Gotta be close.
Six zip in favor of Michael Jordan. Yeah.
Well, at least the Browns have him now.
At least they
and it didn't cost them much to get him, right?
No, not
they
at all.
Passed on him in the draft.
No, it didn't cost him much money at all. Didn't cost any reputations or anything. It was fine.
Multiple draft picks.
Yeah, it's
most
good.
Guaranteed money
it's
all
good.
Time.
It's good.
Joe Flacco brought him to the playoffs. Pretty good.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. That's pretty bad from Dabo there. Just like it's absurd from Jim Harbaugh. What else do you ban in sports? The hip drop is done. No more hip drop tackles with a swivel. Also, for me, I say ban paying for tickets to NFL preseason games. Theo says ban college coaches having the ability to talk about their quarterback as they enter the draft. Ban these things. What else in sports are you banning? 888-760-3776. 888-760-3776. Social media at KLV1063. That's 888-760-3776. Hey, is joint pain affecting your quality of life? At Baptist Health Orthopedic Care, their team's experienced in traditional joint replacement surgery, as well as new, less invasive treatments with the goal of returning you to what you love as quickly as possible. Learn more by visiting baptisthealth.net/ortho today. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care combines its resources of experienced physicians, leading-edge treatments, and technology to provide advanced orthopedic foot and ankle, joint replacement, spine, and sports medicine care. Visit baptisthealth.net/ortho for more information today. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care has offices conveniently located in Palm Beach County through the Florida Keys. Learn more by visiting baptisthealth.net/ortho. Your favorite sports radio talkers, they've dove right in to hip drop tackle. But you know what? None of them made it a day. None of them made it a day. So welcome in to LaVica, Theo, and Stone's Hip Drop Tackle Tuesday.
Woo! Thank you.
I can't get over that. It's so funny. Broken bone.
That last part tough.
What else are you banning in sports? 888-760-3776. 888-760-3776. That is Theo. That is Stone. I am Ken Levick at Theo and Stone, ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3.
It's lights out in Miami. The 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix takes off May 3rd through the 5th. The three-day event is filled with art, music, world-class cuisine, and, of course, top-notch racing. Tickets are available now. Choose from a variety of grandstands, each with a fantastic track view that puts you right in the center of the action and gives you access to the full campus. Visit F1MiamiGP.com. That's F1MiamiGP.com today.
Now, let's check the Bradley Heating and Air Weather Center.
Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning, keeping the Palm Beaches cool since 1980. Visit them today at BradleyAir.com.
Starting off our day with partly to mostly cloudy skies. Not too bad out there. It's pretty quiet, but a stray shower is possible anytime today. Along a windy southeast breeze, those winds blowing anywhere between 20 to 25 miles per hour, gusting up to 35 miles per hour. Now, that's especially along the coast. Temperatures this morning in the low 70s along the coast, 60s inland. Highs today in the low 80s. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on ESPN 106.3.
What's the Anajar Levine difference? When you're injured in a car crash, we focus on your case so you can focus on the one thing that matters most, getting better. I'm Glenn Levine with Anajar Levine. We'll fight to get you the maximum compensation you deserve. Call our legal team right now for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. We'll help you take back control of your life. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office West Palm Beach.
For a PNC pause. PNC Bank is committed to helping the customers and the communities they serve move forward financially. See how they can make a difference for you at PNC.com.
Hey, it's Tina from Josh Cohen and the Home Team, and I wanted to remind you that Jay McLaughlin at the Gardens Mall carries clothing and accessories for women and men. The men's styles can take guys everywhere, from work to weekend to adventure, with clothes featuring standout colors and signature prints. These clothes are perfect to go from the office to the golf course to dinner without a wardrobe change needed. Visit Jay McLaughlin at the Gardens Mall on the upper level near Saks Fifth Avenue.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen. When you are in need of any kind of auto repair, honesty and reliability are everything. Trust the home for honest, reliable service, St. Lucie Battery and Tire. Just like the name, St. Lucie Battery and Tire has all tire and battery brands in stock for cars, trucks, RV, marine, power sport, even golf carts. Major and minor service repairs, free tire pressure, and free battery checks. St. Lucie Battery and Tire, over 50 years in our community. 17 full-service locations, all the way from West Palm Beach to the Treasure Coast. Check them out at slbt.com. That's slbt.com.
What up? This is Dean Thomas from Josh Cohen and the Home Team. And sometimes the daily grind of life can leave me feeling tired and drained. That's why I have Celsius with 7 essential vitamins. Celsius is designed to optimize performance and give me the energy boost that I need. So whether I'm training athletes or I'm covering a UFC fight card, Celsius keeps me cool and refreshed. Get yours today. Celsius, essential energy drinks.
Want to accelerate your career as a manager or executive in the exciting industry of sports? FAU's MBA program in sport management is ranked number one in Florida, 10th in the world. Students learn practical and applied skills from top faculty and experts who work in the industry. The full-time MBA program sets students up for success in the world of sports. Check out FAU Sport Management MBA program today, fau.edu/MBA sport.
Looking for the perfect pre-owned Land Rover? Visit LandRoverPalmBeach.com and shop for the finest collection of Land Rover certified vehicles in Florida. Every certified pre-owned Land Rover vehicle is subjected to a rigorous 165-point inspection and is protected by up to either a 1-year unlimited miles or 2 years 100,000 miles limited warranty and complimentary roadside assistance. Take advantage of 3.9% financing for up to 24 months on select Land Rover models. Call 561-209-7000 for more details today. LandRoverPalmBeach.com.
You are listening to ESPN 106.3.
Hi, this is Blaine Isbell, Corporate Vice President of Team IP. For over 30 years, Team IP has been a national leader in decorated apparel and promotional products. National corporate brands and 22 college bowl games, including the Boca Raton Bowl, make Team IP their partner of choice. Team IP, located right in our community in Stuart, is a proud partner of ESPN West Palm. Contact me anytime at 877-821-8643 or head to teamip.com and take the first step in making Team IP your team to boost your brand.
What's up, Heat fans? This is Jason Jackson from your Miami Heat audio experience. From every earth-shattering dunk,
throw it down,
to every three ball from the land of milk and honey,
for three, splash,
and everything in between.
It's Skyhook, and he called it.
ESPN West Palm has you covered. Make sure you are always locked in with your favorite station to catch every single Heat game with me and the gang. It's time to ball, yo.
Hey, it's Josh Korn here to tell you about my friends at Truist Bank. Care is more than what's said. It's really about what's done. Whether it's helping you improve your financial well-being or supporting local small businesses, Truist inspires and builds better lives and communities by being there, listening, and making real connections. When you start with care, you get a different kind of bank. To learn more, visit Truist.com, T-R-U-I-S-T.com, or a Truist branch near you. Truist Bank, member FDIC.
From the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios, it's LaVica, Theo, and Stone, presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book on ESPN 106.3.
Just a little good old-fashioned cancel culture on today's show.
Sure.
What else in sports needs to be banned? We can't tackle anymore. Can't tackle anymore in football. I mean, it does lend the question. I'm fine with protecting players, and apparently I was reading there were 250 instances of the swivel hip drop tackle this year and a number of players hurt by it. But there's no way in real time that these officials are going to be able to determine what's a legal hip drop tackle and what's not.
But maybe that's
there's
best.
There's no way.
Maybe that's best,
it
right?
It might be. And maybe after the fact adjudications or rulings on that will be better. Because in real time, that's going to be a mess. That's going to be a disaster.
You don't trust the programs that you're putting in place right now? Like the classes that these referees are showing up to, the demonstrations they're putting on display at these fields? Like they're going through what it looks like.
How would you grade NFL officiating? You think it's good? You think that it's consistent? You think that it is across the board the best it's ever been?
Top five, one of the top five toughest jobs in the United States of America.
Okay. It doesn't mean that.
I think like a B+.
Okay.
I'll go B plus.
It doesn't change the fact that there are so many damn rules in professional football. Adding something like this, where it's truly going to be, especially with the speed of the game, with the size of the people, a split second judgment call.
Yeah.
And this could absolutely change the complexion of games, which I'd prefer it not to do.
I'm afraid of that happening, but also I think the biggest fear or problem with this is. Remember last year when, like, on like the Tuesday after a week of the NFL, we kept seeing all those reports of the fines for these mundane plays where it's like a running back on the chip block and he gets a helmet to helmet fine, and that's a $10,000 hit, a $20,000 hit, a $15,000 hit there, here and there. It felt like last year was like one of the most fined years on players' pockets. And if you're adding the hip drop tackle to the list of things you can be fined for, are the owners just scraping these players' pockets to donate to charity to write off now? Like, at this point, are they just finding another reason to fine players?
How do you think the NFL's billion-dollar industry? Got to take that money back. The owners got to take that money back.
That's like 10 and 15K just here and there. It's some of these guys, you know, of course, you know, if it's like Christian Wilkins, I mean, it's nothing. But what about who's your guy that's replacing Christian Wilkins on the Dolphins that you keep talking about?
Zach Sealer.
He's not making Christian Wilkins money. That those little $10,000, $15,000 fines, they stack up.
I'm a sealer feeler. No.
That's a little.
You didn't think that one.
A little
through.
Touchy. No. Touch and go.
Touch.
It's literally.
Yeah. Touch. Sealer feeler.
You don't want to be a sealer feeler.
I don't know what else to do then. Zach attack.
There you go. Just stick.
Zach
on that.
Pack.
You're in the Zach Pack.
The Zach Pack.
You're in the Zach Pack. Filler seems like you need to be at some kind of registry.
I trust Roger Goodell. I mean, when has he ever steered us in the wrong direction?
When has Roger Goodell ever steered us in the wrong direction? You're right.
I trust NFL officiating.
You're right.
Roger Goodell.
Uh-huh. True champion of what's right, Roger Goodell.
I at least have
faith. You
trust
Shohei Ohtani?
Now, Shohei's a whole nother thing. See, but I do. I have faith. You guys don't have faith. You guys are just knocking it. The only thing that scares me is how do you tackle Travis Kelce? How do you tackle
Derrick Henry? You don't.
How do you Sam Laporta? How do you bring these guys down at this point?
This swivel hip drop tackle, it's a rugby style tackle. Is it banned in rugby? No. Rugby is 10 times the man sport football is. Rugby is 10 times the man sport that American football is. Is rugby 10 times the man sport that American football is? 888-760-3776, 888-760-3776. I say rugby is 10 times manlier American football,
no,
especially with
the
all the rules now.
No. The answer is no. I'm not going to let you get away with this.
In rugby, players are taught to take half a body. Right, you can contort your body.
How do you know?
He's about to get real technical right here.
I've played a sport pretty similar to rugby.
It's not though. Not anymore.
Yes, it is. It's very similar. And what
you play quarterback?
Players, and doesn't mean that I don't sit there and watch hundreds of guys run around and clang and bang all day long. In rugby, you're taught to take half a body. You can contort your body before contact to where you're not taking full blow. In football,
but now
you
take half a body in American professional football, but you can't swivel.
But these guys are coming at a much faster speed than rugby players are.
That's disrespectful.
How do you what?
Oh, you're just assuming that football players are faster than rugby players?
Kevin says it's banned in rugby. So that eliminates my whole point. Kevin messages in, it's banned in rugby.
Thank you, Kevin. Ken, stop. It's fake
news. All
right,
never mind.
Ken's over here using points confidently.
All right, never mind.
Thankfully, we have guys like Kevin to check you.
Never mind. All right, forget I ever said any of that. Hey, why don't you tell us about the fine folks at Kaiser Golf, Theo?
I would love to because there are no hip drop tackles in golf either. There aren't. And even if there were, I'm sure I would still be working on how to execute it just like I'm trying to work on my irons and my driver. And more specifically now, I do need to tune up my putter, right? My putter's got to get stronger. I am a little over 24 hours away from hitting the Palm Beach par 3 with our guy, Pierre Garçon.
Can I ask this?
Yeah.
On the let's get a ruling right now. Palm Beach par 3.
Yeah.
Theo's going to play it with Pierre Garçon.
Yes.
If he birdies at the Palm Beach par 3, does that count as his birdie for the year?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Why would even if every hole is par 3?
Give him all the chances
he can get. That's like saying I'm going to go to mini golf, and if I birdie there, that works.
That's totally unfair, Ken.
All right, we're going to put that out there, too.
Maybe for a competent golfer, those rules apply.
How many holes at the Palm Beach par 3?
Let's go 18.
No, I don't think there's 18 holes at the Palm Beach par 3.
Well, there's not 18 par 3s. At the Palm Beach par 3 course.
God, what is it? This show has just come to a screeching
halt.
Yeah, it's a true stat.
Look that up. You continue to bestow us the virtues of Kaiser Golf, and I'll look that
up. Yes, we'll look up the specs on the course. But either way, no matter how many holes there are, I'm closer to birdieing them than not, thanks to the work I've been doing with the Kaiser University Golf Coaching Center.
It is 18 holes.
A full 18 holes, like I said.
Shut my mic off.
This guy's been throwing out this fake stuff left and right, but you get the real true stuff from the coaches like my guy Coach Pete at the Kaiser University Golf Coaching Center. Like I said, I've been working on my irons, working on my driver. I need to shore up my putting, and they have this beautiful putting green with different levels of slope, so many different holes. You've seen putting greens before, right? This one, state of the art.
Yeah.
And just like the indoor facilities, which have three different hitting bays with ball flight technology, everything you have outdoors at Kaiser University for the Golf Coaching Center, also pristine, and it helps you get your golf game right. My coach, Pete, looking forward to my next Saturday morning with him. Hopefully I can birdie tomorrow so I can show these fools here that with perseverance and the proper coaching, anything is possible. Maybe that should be the next slogan for the Kaiser University Golf Coaching Center. I can't tell you if that's true or not, but I can tell you, if you want lessons, KaiserGolfCenter.com. KaiserGolfCenter.com. Ask for Pete. Tell him Theo sent you. And maybe, again, in 2 days from now, when we're talking about Kaiser Golf Center, I'll be talking about the birdie I got at the Palm Beach par three.
Question for you, Theo. Golf related.
What up? Talk to me.
Do you have a natural draw or a natural fade?
More of a natural fade. More of a natural fade.
Off the tee box with the driver.
Right off the tee with the driver. It's going to hook left. It's going to hook a little left.
That's a draw.
But I'm a southpaw. I'm a southpaw.
You golf lefty.
So, Stone, before you try to check me on my terminology, just know I've been with my boy Pete. And he told me what's good, and he told me to get that foot. See, I just got to close the club a little bit. Close the club
definitely
head.
Definitely do.
And make sure I'm not – I was striking it with the foot of my driver. And I'm serious right now. People think I'm joking, but that literally was one of my problems. I was striking it with the foot more, and I'm getting closer to the center of the club head. I'm closing the driver more, and that's getting me more straight ones. So, thanks, Stone. You just teed me up, and I sent that thing 350 right down the line.
If you did that, though, on the par 3 course, that's not good.
Ken, there's a toe and a heel. What's a foot?
I said foot.
Yeah, I think a heel.
I meant the toe, though.
Oh, the toe.
I was hitting it with the toe.
For sure.
Which was making it
right.
Hook.
I love right. this, man. I love this.
I'm really learning golf, for real.
What you love? That he's
yeah,
getting
I'm taking it
in
seriously.
Tune with golf.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I'm really
yeah,
serious.
That's good.
Because real talk, I knew nothing of golf before coming to Palm Beach County, for real. I'd gotten out there, golfed a little bit here and there, but I'm an absolute amateur, a novice.
By the way, I saw Steve Pollitzino. Is he on today? Ask Steve's.
Just an impromptu ask.
It's on
Steve's.
My calendar, but like I haven't heard anything
he
from
popped
anybody.
He popped into the studio here.
So it looked like he was going to like lunch.
Yeah, he definitely was going to lunch.
I'm
going to
chalk that up as a no. He's not on today.
Hopefully we get him in person if he does stop back in, but popped into the studio.
My God, hopefully. What else should be banned in sports? 888-760-3776. 888-760-3776. Social media at KLV1063. 888-760-3776. Before we get to social media, there's a lot of it. Stone, what else are you banning in addition to the hip drop tackle in sports?
This one I'm so serious about. We've kind of been laughing some of them off, but I mean this one, and I mean it with passion. Stop carrying the bonus over into overtime. This is in regards to college basketball. We're in March Madness right now. It's already a hard enough sport to watch at times when these teams are fouling each other and they can't buy a basket. We're finishing with scores like 60 to 70, 60 to 42. I mean, we saw what Virginia's
you know what else
done.
Is tough when people give scores backwards like Stone just did, 60 to 70.
He does that a lot.
I do it a lot.
A lot. You know what that is? It's amateur.
No, it's a tennis thing. I get tennis on the brain. But stop carrying the bonus into overtime. They're already...
You shouldn't be able to reset your foul total in overtime.
For the viewer experience, the last 2-3 minutes of a game is 45 minutes long. There's 18 fouls every 60 seconds. You got players bricking free throws down the stretch. And then we go to overtime. Free basketball, they say. Well... First drive to the basket in overtime, we get another foul. Could be an off-ball foul, and they're walking to the line. So overtime in college basketball lasts a good 45 minutes. And like I said, it's already lasted 6 hours because they keep fouling each other, and every touch is a foul.
All right.
Stop carrying the bonus over.
Here's my solution, because I think that that's a little lame, but fine. I can commiserate with
lame.
You. All right. Here's my proposal. Once you start overtime... Three team fouls put you back in
Fine.
The bonus. The third team foul will put you in the bonus.
Love it.
Okay. As opposed to a seventh team foul in a half.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Teams can't even get in rhythm.
Okay. Like, that's fine. I think that's good.
From
All
a
right.
game flow perspective.
Good. So,
ban carrying over the fouls.
Did we come to an agreement here?
I love that.
Yeah. Three team fouls will put you in the bonus in overtime.
That's amazing.
Okay. All right.
Take that up with, who do I need to take that up with?
Don't know. Don't know, actually.
Greg Sankey, he gets things done.
Greg Sankey apparently is the gatekeeper of all things college basketball, SEC commissioner, so perfect. Take it up with him. I asked on social media, at KLV1063, if Theo Dorsey registers a birdie on a par 3 course, does it count as his birdie for the year? Johnny messages in, no.
How does that even make sense? It's a birdie.
No, because your percentage goes way up.
Yeah. Oh, your chances, that's like cheating.
Theo's.
No, but no, you need to do it. You need to do it on a regulation, even
on
if it's immunity,
course.
On a regular course with
but
par fours, par fives.
If I've never parred any hole ever in the history of my golf game, and then I par on any par three, it still count. It still is a hole where you're supposed to.
I don't know, man.
And just because I get more tries at it, that's like, okay, if I go golfing every day, does it not count? And I hit a bunch of regulation courses, but some of them have par threes. You know, like.
There's something kind of cheap about that. I don't know. There's something.
See, but Theo's percentage goes from 2.4% to like 3.1%.
Yeah.
When the, you know, the average or he's scratch right. or, you know, even 15 to 20 handicap, your percentage is going to go from 35 to 50. Like yeah. there's a 50% chance you knock down a bird.
He's not wrong. I'm that bad at golf to where it shouldn't give me that much more of an advantage. Now,
I didn't mean it. Yeah.
He's true. I'm not even going to lie.
But that's like saying like Theo was playing competitive basketball. He's never hit a three. His goal is to hit a three and the defense backs off of him and everybody cheers him on.
No.
Like, come on, Theo, shoot your three.
Bang.
And he makes
three
it,
ball.
And everybody celebrates. And then he can say, I made a three.
It's more like I've never hit a three before. My goal is to hit a three. And we run five straight plays with me coming off of, like, down screens to get an open look at a three versus me coming up the court, you know what I'm saying, dribble, hezzy, cross, step back, pull that thing from the, like, left wing.
I don't believe in that type of basketball. I believe in team basketball, so I don't know what you're talking about there. That's a little too individual for my preference.
I agree.
We don't need hezzies. We don't need step backs. How about you catch and shoot in rhythm?
That is whack.
And as far as
that's what my par three is going to be.
He's got Dusty May on the mind.
That's
like,
right.
True
good basketball.
True good basketball.
Whatever. That stuff's gone.
What you were talking about as far as.
Thank you for reminding me.
As far as drawing up five straight plays to knock one down, I mean, the Warriors do that every night they take the floor.
But they do it with guys that are good at shooting threes. They're not doing it for Draymond Green.
Guys, yes, they are accomplished at shooting threes.
I'm Draymond Green stepping out there on the golf course.
I want to get your guys. I also asked on social media, is rugby before I was told that, oh, yeah, the swivel hip drop in rugby is also banned.
That's probably what
didn't
made
know
it.
That. I was spouting off like I do.
Yeah.
Is rugby... what did I say? Five times or ten times?
You said ten, which
rugby,
is crazy.
Is rugby 10 times manlier than American football? Here's this response from Caden. I play rugby. It's a sport just like any other. It's pointless to prescribe masculinity to rugby, let alone any sport, when there's almost always a women's version of it as well.
Dang. Are you getting canceled?
Hey, it fits. We're banning things today, and I believe I just got canceled.
I think you did.
Caden, that was not my intention to...
No!
That's deep.
Don't
back off.
Women who play rugby, because I know women who play rugby.
Yeah.
They're 10 times manlier than me. Was that the right thing to say?
I don't know, but don't back off your spot here.
Was that a good thing to say?
then he would say define manly, and then you get yourself in all kinds of pretzels. You're gonna get all twisted up here on a swivel hip drop tackle Tuesday.
Here, women can do anything a man can.
Yes.
There.
Would masculine have been better here?
No. It would have been equally as damaging.
It's about the same thing.
But equally as damaging.
There's no getting out of that.
This is not going well for me today. This has been the worst opening hour of a show I've ever had. I mean, just saying things.
Yeah.
Spouting off.
You had
without
so many
knowledge
wrong
of it.
Takes, yeah.
Canceled.
You've gotten canceled already. Now, if we were, like, the odds coming into every show of who's going to get canceled, like, Stone's usually
the leader in the clubhouse, always.
We've canceled this guy, like, seven
this
times
guy's,
at least.
Forget leader in the clubhouse. He's been in the clubhouse for hours, down to martinis. That's like, always how we enter the show.
We're like, wow. But it was Ken Lavica. You're least likely.
Yeah.
This was an upset. March Madness.
I made up seven shots in nine holes, and here I am the leader in the clubhouse now.
Too much coffee?
No. I think what happened yesterday was an emotional day for me,
that's
and I
true.
Think that I'm unstable right now.
It's awesome.
Like, is that a good thing to say?
It's like a trauma dump. Like,
yeah,
trauma dump
I am going through. I you know, though, like, we're talking about me having a trauma dump when at 2 in the morning a freaking bridge collapsed.
Oh my gosh.
That was in Baltimore. Sickening. So, like, I can't sit here and say, oh, I was so affected when a freaking bridge collapse happened. Yeah. The second largest truss bridge in the world in Baltimore. So, I guess what I'm trying to say is, God, do I suck today. Let's take a break. I've got a lot of other things to say, too, in a shocking turn of events. We'll get to your social media and more people weighing in on whether or not Theo, if he birdies on a par three course, if it actually counts as his goal of a birdie for the year.
I'll be.
That's Theo. That's Stone. I'm Ken. and I'm canceled. It's LeVic and Theo in Stone on ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE. This is ESPN 106.3.
Panthers fans, get ready for the excitement. Don't miss out on the 30th anniversary season of your Panthers. Single game tickets are now available for all 23-24 regular season home games at floridapanthers.com. Come rock Amerant Bank Arena and celebrate the 30th anniversary with us. Go Cats!
Reinhardt out of his own end with 10. Reinhardt over the blue line, gives to Barkov. 5 seconds left in overtime. Here's Reinhardt on the doorstep of the back end. He scores! Let's go home, baby!
Honey, wake up. I can't sleep with all your snoring.
Sorry, dear. I'll go sleep in the guest room.
That's it. I'm fed up. I'm setting an appointment for you with Dr. Goldhaber.
Do you or a loved one suffer from snoring? Do you find that you're losing your own night of sleep, even changing rooms? Dr. Neil Goldhaber has been treating ear, nose, and throat patients in Florida for over 25 years. In addition to being the nasal and sinus expert, he also treats patients with snoring and sleep apnea. Located in Boynton Beach, Dr. Goldhaber's state-of-the-art in-office procedures help improve breathing and nasal symptoms. Ear, nose, and throat problems are often the cause of snoring. Schedule an appointment so you can breathe better today and sleep better tonight. Visit GoldhaberSinus.com or call 561-734-3636.
Don't tell your neighbor to see Dr. Goldhaber.
PNC Bank is committed to making a difference in the lives of the customers and communities they serve by helping them move forward financially. As a Main Street bank, PNC is always working to make it easier for their customers to achieve their goals and plan for the future, whether that's through innovative digital solutions or in person. PNC is proud to be part of the South Florida community. See how PNC Bank can make a difference for you at pnc.com/tech. PNC Bank, National Association, member FDIC.
We're proud of our parents.
Want to know why?
Because they work for the school district of Palm Beach County.
There's lots of great jobs.
With paid vacation, holidays off, health care, and retirement.
You can be on the same schedule as your kids.
Come work at the school district of Palm Beach County. You'll see why it's your best choice.
Join us at the Team Palm Beach Schools Job Fair. Register at palmbeachschools.org/jobfair. That's palmbeachschools.org/jobfair.
Hard Rock Bet presents Legal in Florida.
You can bet the game on Hard Rock Bet. No more betting inside your head.
Now Hard Rock Bet is legal in Florida. Now Hard Rock Bet is legal in Florida.
Legal in Florida.
It's safe, it's legal. We'll repeat that it is legal.
Top rated sportsbook, and it's the only one that's legal.
Get a no-regret first bet up to $100 when you sign up now. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 and over and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMITTED.
Did you miss this?
People ask me, does he really talk that way? And I said, sometimes, yeah. He just cranks it up a little bit on the ice. Let me ask you a question, Mr. Pukey Puke.
Do you have a crush on me? You chose to look up my name, watch my basketball tape, look at my interviews. You chose that on your time, not when you're on the clock. Do you want to kiss me, Josh? Get my name out of your mouth, dude.
Do I want to kiss you? Is that what you said?
It's Josh Cohen in the home team.
This always happens between you two. You guys always go back and forth like Tom and Jerry.
Weekdays at 4 on ESPN 106.3.
Hi, I'm Michael Manzo, owner and founder of Manzo's Italian Deli. And I...
Stop, Dad. After 20 years, people are tired of hearing your voice.
Yeah, and your lame-ass commercials.
Fresh prosciutto, mozzarella, outstanding.
Oh, please.
There's only one reason Manzo's has voted number one deli in Palm Beach County for 20 years. Our mother.
She makes sure you prepare everything from scratch using only the freshest ingredients.
Manzo's Italian Deli is located on Palm Beach Lakes Boulevard, right next to Rain Dancers.
Is that a strip club?
No, it's a steakhouse. Manzo's is open weekdays from 8 to 5 and offers free delivery. So stop by or call 697-9411. That's 697-9411.
We also specialize in hot and cold catering for corporate functions and special events.
Just ask anyone who was at my last birthday party.
06B. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
From the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios, it's LaVica, Theo, and Stone. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book on ESPN 106.3.
Still a couple of days away from college basketball on the men's side resuming. I suppose on the women's side as well. Stone, you've got a you've got some hot Panthers Bruins action tonight.
Ooh, Panthers Bruins. Hard Rock Bet giving out the boost for the Florida Panthers at +105. Originally they're -135. I'm though rocking with the Brew Crew tonight. Big time, heavy. Bruins all day. Wow. Anybody want to smoke, you know where to find me. Rosemary Avenue, front door. I'll be the one to answer.
Stop challenging people to fights.
He's never even there to answer the door.
No, it's never going to happen.
Somebody else.
But seriously, I'm taking a trip down to Florida Live. I'm excited. Panthers, Bruins. I'm all over the Brew Crew tonight. Boston or die!
It's also not FLA Live. It's Amerant Bank Arena, but that's fine.
You know, I knew there was a chance.
You went for it, though.
That they put a name sponsor on it months ago? Yes.
You went for it. I like when people go for it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's been my whole first hour.
Yeah.
I mean, go for it, and I've been wrong every time, but I've been going for it. Stone, though, tonight, the reason I brought up the Panthers and the Bruins is because Stone backs the Bruins because he always puts money on them. And tonight he's going to put money on them via Hard Rock Bet. So even though college basketball's off tonight, have no fear. There's hockey. There's NBA. There's plenty for you. Hard Rock Bet, legal in Florida. Hard Rock Bet is Florida's sports book, the only legal place to bet on sports. You can bet on your favorite teams tonight for Stone, the Bruins, every night on the top-rated Hard Rock Bet app. Easy sign-up, fast deposits, withdrawals, PayPal, Venmo cards, and more. Props, parlays, live play-by-play betting. Bet anywhere in the confines of our comfy state of Florida. All you have to do to get started, download Hard Rock Bet on the App Store, Google Play Store. Go online, hardrock.bet. And, man, that app, it is clean, straightforward, and easy to use. And that no-regret first bet, up to $100, a game changer. Try Hard Rock Bet now. Get a no-regret first bet up to $100. Use that no-regret first bet on parlays, props, overs, and more. That is Hard Rock Bet, Florida's sportsbook, offered by Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 or over, physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Call 1-888-ADMIT-IT. That's Hard Rock Bet. On social media, Ricky messages in that, yes, it counts on a par three course if Theo birdies. There's 18 pars, 18 par threes, and it's beautiful there. The longest hole might be 165 yards.
Yeah.
Here's what I equate that to. If you play and birdie on a par three, you have 18 chances on the highest percentage holes in golf to get a birdie. That's like saying, oh, yeah, I went deep in high school, and your baseball team was playing on a softball field.
Okay.
That's what I equate that to. It doesn't really count.
It's a little extreme.
It doesn't really
count.
That
is a little extreme. I'll also say this. The way that the game of golf is structured, a person of my skill level, and I know that there are percentages and all that, well, the person of my skill level, I do feel like I have a similar amount of chance on a par three than I do a par five, because I don't still have as much control over where I'm sending the thing. Like
I know that's not a fact.
I feel like you say that, but
a typical round of golf, you have what, five par threes?
Sure.
He is improving his chances tenfold of getting a birdie, because instead of five par threes, which is the easiest hole to par, or to birdie, he's now expanding that from 5 to 18.
So let's just lay it out in math then. You know math better than us.
No,
okay,
I don't.
So if there's 5 holes.
What are you talking about?
If there's 5 holes, and now there's 15, because at a par 3 course, not all 18 are par 3s.
They are. All 18 of those are par 3s, though.
At this part,
it's a par 3 course.
Most par 3s are all par 3s, though.
Not remotely true, like,
really?
At all.
I played 2 par 3 courses before, and both of them were all par 3s, and this third one I'm about to play is all par 3s, so 3 out of the 3 par 3s I've played.
Sorry, Ricky corrected me, by the way, 4 par 3s on an 18-hole course.
So if there's 4, and you multiply that by 4.
That's 16.
Right.
So then
close
you need
enough, because you can't do 5, because that's too many. So let's stay under the number here. You're just multiplying Theo's chances by 4. So if he's already got a 1% chance, now he's got a 4% chance.
Mike says, yes, it counts. But I don't know. It might count, but like, I feel like there's an asterisk there. Just like Barry, he's the Barry Bonds of golf. If he birdies,
I'll take that
on a par three course. You got to put an asterisk there.
I will be the Barry Bonds of golf.
Oh man,
I was the John Schmoltz. Somehow, my legend keeps growing. Barry Bonds, I'll take it. And also, I've gotten par before, and guess what? It came on a par four. So, what are we doing? You know what I'm saying? Like it was luck. I hit two good shots in a row,
right?
And then I two putted it in. Like,
well, that'd be a par.
I know. That's what I said.
This is going well. All right,
I'm birdieing a par three tomorrow, and damn it, it's going to count.
If he birdies, it counts.
I will birdie, and it will count.
KYP.
And it will be on video.
Know your personnel.
By the way, in hour number two, we're going to get to our social media finally on what people think should be banned in sports. Also, grade things. Lavica, Theo, and Stone, grade things. Classes in session on this Tuesday, and we play a new game called Guess What Mike Tannenbaum Said Now.
Oh, I love it.
That's Theo, that's Stone. I'm Ken. Lavica, Theo, and Stone, ESPN 106.3.
Amateur Levine Accident Attorneys, call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3 WUUB Jupiter, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen. Are you or a loved one experiencing memory loss, misplacing your keys, or forgetting people's names? Memory diseases affect not only the individual, but the entire family. Those over 50 should do memory screenings as part of their annual routine checkups. Brain Matters Research, with offices in Palm Beach County and the Treasure Coast, is offering complimentary memory screenings. Go to memoryscreeningsflorida.com. That's memoryscreeningsflorida.com. Brain Matters Research, making your memories matter.
Time now for a PNC pause. PNC Bank is committed to making a difference in the lives of the customers they serve in the South Florida community. See how at PNC.com. You're listening to ESPN 106.3.
You're listening to ESPN 106.3, presented by Rubenstein Law. 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Car accident, truck accident, Uber or Lyft accident, or slip and fall? Call Rubenstein Law. Call 1-800-FL-LEGAL and visit one of our offices throughout Florida.
What's up, Heat fans? This is Jason Jackson from your Miami Heat audio experience. From every earth-shattering dunk,
throw it down,
to every three ball from the land of milk and honey,
for three, splash,
and everything in between.
It's Skyhook, and he called it.
ESPN West Palm has you covered. Make sure you are always locked in with your favorite station to catch every single Heat game with me and the gang. It's time to ball, yo.
Time now for the Land Rover Palm Beach Player of the Week. Supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. Every Player of the Week is eligible to win a scholarship at the end of the year. This year, a $25,000 scholarship will be awarded to an athlete, with $10,000 going to the winner's high school athletic department. Land Rover Palm Beach, above and beyond. Here's Cade Chumsley.
Our Land Rover Palm Beach Player of the Week is Palm Beach Gardens wrestler George Bravo. George took third place at the state championships earlier this month, and this week he got to share with me some of his favorite memories from wrestling with the Gators.
There's so many memories that I've created, even with losses and wins, and I just like the overall experience that I've had with wrestling and going to tournaments in the offseason, going up to Tampa, Orlando, meeting a bunch of friends. I just like that, you know, that connection that I've made with people through wrestling.
Congratulations, George, on being selected the Land Rover Palm Beach Player of the Week. We look forward to seeing you down the road.
Hey, Steph Prince here, General Manager of ESPN West Palm, to tell you about a team that has meant a lot to me and this community for a long time. Bob and the team at Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning have been helping me stay cool for years, whether at home or in the office. And living in South Florida with three kids, I don't know what I'd do without them. Family owned and operated, serving Royal Palm Beach and beyond since 1980. Let the knowledgeable and trained team at Bradley help you with your residential and commercial needs, installation, repair, seasonal maintenance, upgrades of all makes and styles and models of HVAC equipment, and so much more. Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning does things right the first time and makes the process smooth, stress-free, and most importantly, keeps you cool. Give them a call at 561-793-7497. That's 561-793-7497. Or BradleyAir.com. Any need, big or small? Trust the amazing team at Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning.
Hey, it's Dean Thomas. If you are serious about a career in golf, check out the College of Golf at Keiser University. Enroll in Keiser's Golf Management Program and get your degree from the best in the business. 3 PGA Master Professionals and an LPGA Hall of Famer on staff. You can earn your degree on campus or online in just 16 months. Scholarships and financial aid are available. Take your swing at a rewarding career in golf at Keiser University. More info at collegeofgolf.keiseruniversity.edu.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen here to tell you about my favorite place to buy a vehicle. Go see my friends over at Ed Morse Automotive Group. They've got a huge selection of new and pre-owned vehicles. That's right, inventory is back. So you can shop, test drive Cadillacs, Toyotas, Hondas, Chevys, Buicks, GMCs, and quality pre-owned vehicles. Every vehicle is backed by Morse at 5 convenient locations throughout South Florida. Family-owned and operated since 1946. Let me tell you, this is the place you want to do business. See for yourself at edmorse.com. Remember, you're always backed by Morse.
When it comes to choosing a health plan, you can trust the members who have experienced it firsthand. Humana is proud to offer a Medicare Advantage plan in Florida that earned 5 out of 5 stars. 5 stars is the highest rating possible. It's based on real members' experiences, and it's decided by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. Our Humana Gold Plus HMO earned 5 out of 5 stars. That means a few things. It means members get outstanding customer service. It means we connect them with excellent preventive care and chronic condition support. Most of all, it means you have a trustworthy option for a Medicare Advantage plan. Explore our 5-star Humana Gold Plus HMO at humana5star.com. Humana, a more human way to healthcare. Every year, Medicare evaluates plans based on a 5-star rating system. Humana is a Medicare Advantage HMO organization with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in any Humana plan depends on contract renewal.
Hi, I'm Ken Levick, and your house is probably disgusting. In South Florida, your indoor air quality can suffer. You need EDS air conditioning, allergy season, pollen, dust, pollutants, all inside. EDS has a solution. Get a free home air quality assessment, plus save $500 on an air purification bundle. EDS, an RGF Black Label dealer, that means EDS can help you with the new Remy Halo air purifier, cleaning your indoor air, even killing COVID-19. EDS is yes. Get a free home air quality assessment, purify your air, breathe better, EDSairconditioning.com.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen. When you are in need of any kind of auto repair, honesty and reliability are everything. Trust the home for honest, reliable service, St. Lucie Battery and Tire. Just like the name, St. Lucie Battery and Tire has all tire and battery brands in stock for cars, trucks, RV, marine, power sport, even golf carts. Major and minor service repairs, free tire pressure, and free battery checks. St. Lucie Battery and Tire, over 50 years in our community. 17 full-service locations, all the way from West Palm Beach to the Treasure Coast. Check them out at slbt.com. That's slbt.com.
Want to accelerate your career as a manager or executive in the exciting industry of sports? FAU's MBA program in sport management is ranked number one in Florida, 10th in the world. Students learn practical and applied skills from top faculty and experts who work in the industry. The full-time MBA program sets students up for success in the world of sports. Check out FAU Sport Management MBA program today, fau.edu/MBA sport.
Hey, it's Tina from Josh Cohen and the Home Team. Celsius is my go-to for all the good vibes. Whether I'm at the beach, hitting the gym, or hanging out with friends, Celsius keeps me refreshed and energized. Packed with 7 essential vitamins, it's the perfect drink for my active lifestyle. Try exciting new flavors like Cosmic Vibe or Lemon Lime. There's even on-the-go powder sticks so you can bring the good vibes with you wherever you go. Purchase your favorite flavor at your local retailer today. Celsius, essential energy drinks.
All right, so RG3 weighed in.
Hip drop, molly wop, drop, and spun on my top.
I think he came off the top.
No.
No way.
He doesn't come off the top with anything.
We weighed in.
Hip drop, molly wop, drop, and spun on my top.
You guys are disrespecting Robert Griffin III. Hip drop, molly wop, drop, and spun on my top.
Now you're underestimating the talent. Now you're disrespecting me. Yeah, disrespecting this guy. He's good off the top.
Off
RG3.
My top. Off the top. Off the top. And molly wop. Wop, 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 wop.
From the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios, it's LaVica, Theo, and Stone, presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book on ESPN 106.3.
Hello? Stone, what just happened there?
Well, what's up?
Oh, man, are we on drugs?
It felt like it just now listening to that, that mashup.
That was well done.
That was incredible.
That was extremely well done. I just thought, Stone, that you would have like music coming in as well. All right, there's hour number two. So we've been talking about what in sports needs to be banned. What in sports needs to be banned? The hip drop tackle, banned with a swivel. Hip drop tackle. I personally think that nobody should ever have to pay to attend an NFL preseason game again. Ban ticket sales for NFL preseason games. You should be able to just walk right in. It should be free to the general public. Theo says that that college coaches should no longer be able to. They should be banned from talking about their quarterbacks who are entering the NFL draft. And Stone, what was yours again?
Stop carrying the bonus over to overtime in college basketball.
Oh, yeah, in college basketball, stop carrying the bonus over into overtime. And then we came to an agreement. Three team fouls would put you in the bonus then in an extra session. Like that's it. Good. I think that works. Let's go to social media. Before I do that, the FAU MBA Sport Management Program, fau.edu/MBA Sport. The FAU MBA Sport Management Program, been doing it since the year 2000, your path to the sports industry. The FAU MBA Sport Management Program, fau.edu/MBA Sport. They have the ability to help you find the path you want to take into the sports industry. You can take courses online or on campus in Boca Raton. The FAU MBA Sport Management Program, fau.edu/MBA Sport. fau.edu/MBA Sport. The FAU MBA Sport Management Program. By the way, if you're scoring at home, Dusty May has just been introduced formally as the head coach at Michigan, and he looks really weird in a yellow tie. Really, really weird in a yellow tie. It is jarring, in fact. What else in sports should be banned on social media? Dave says all talk and opinion shows.
What else?
Thanks, Dave.
That's not nice.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
Yeah.
It's not going
to
happen.
The Vicar Theo and Stone that's here right. to stay.
That's right.
Yeah.
Let's see. Who? Study Hall says hats off in clubhouses.
Hats off in clubhouses. This is a golf
ban. Hats off in clubhouses?
He's talking about golf clubhouse.
So you have to have your hat off when you're in the clubhouse, or you should ban people from taking their hats off?
As soon as you walk into that clubhouse, take off your cap off.
You should ban people wearing their hats inside of the clubhouse.
Yes.
It's like one of those unwritten rules.
That's stupid.
It's a little disrespectful to be walking in there with the hat.
If you're raised military, in the South too, you're raised to take your hats off when you come indoors.
Yeah, when you come to grandma's house. Not when you're just hanging out somewhere having a couple beers.
I mean, I would assume the clubhouse is a place where you're supposed to have reverence, right? Like golf is that, really kind of stuffy, like, oh my gosh, let's be really respectful and
should
nice.
Should you show reverence to the 19th hole at your local clubhouse? 888-760-3776, 888-760-3776. Traditionally, the place where you you overindulge on alcohol and make lewd comments to the waitress. Is that the place you should be showing reverence and take off your hat? The 19th hole, 888-760-3776. I worked at a country club, made many observations in the clubhouse from members who were done with the golf round, and let me tell you, there was nothing reverent about that.
Yeah.
The only thing that was beneficial to me is those dudes getting drunk, saying, hey, could you take my clubs to my car? Take clubs to the car, $20 bill, and then they leave and probably shouldn't have been allowed to drive. There we go.
Yeah.
That's my experience in a clubhouse bar after members are done with their round at a country club.
But you're talking about the bar. What about like in the pro shop, in the auditorium?
Auditorium at a club. What are you talking about? What does he think a clubhouse is?
And the
you think this is a high school?
No, there are some clubhouses that have like big rooms and
right, but not an auditorium.
Like almost like an auditorium. They have events there. They do.
Yeah, you mean a banquet hall?
Banquet hall.
Yes.
Yeah. What? An auditorium is not that far off from a banquet hall.
Yes,
they serve similar purposes.
An auditorium has like a stage and it has like seating.
Some of them have stages. Okay. Y'all need to.
All right, that's fine.
Most times when I go to golf courses, it's not to golf; it's to cover events. And a lot of these golf courses I go to have these clubhouses with these very extensive interiors designed.
What's your favorite clubhouse auditorium?
I've yet to come across one in my entire life, and I've golfed a good 100,000 times more.
Austin says, "Let's ban grown men autograph seekers." Now
that's not nice.
Here's what I would say. If you're a place like Palm Beach Autographs and you have people coming out, you can be a grown man, come out, pay money, get your autograph. But if you're shoving little kids out of the way at Citi Field to try and get your baseball signed and you're a 40-year-old man, that's a problem.
What if you're a Hall of Fame tight end in his 50s and you see maybe the greatest shooter of all time in the tunnels of an NBA arena?
What do you mean?
Shannon Sharpe when he went and got the autograph from Steph Curry like last week?
But that's like in the privacy of like the tunnel. It's not like he was hanging over the rail of the stands and pushing kids out of the way.
And Shannon's not going to sell those kicks. He's going to put them up on display.
Yeah. I'm not for or against it. I'm just saying when is it proper for you to be able to get an autograph as a grown man? And I would also say I don't want to patronize the people that do because like fans are kind of what make sports as popular as they are. Like the NFL is this big multi-billion dollar industry because people in their 40s and 50s and 60s and 70s do care to that extent. So I don't want to. It is. If we don't care about the NFL, it wouldn't make money.
If you're over the age of 25, you don't need to be seeking out at an NFL game an NFL autograph or a baseball autograph. Or like you just don't. Like go like a contributing member of American capitalistic society and go to an autograph convention. Go to like Palm Beach Autographs, pay some money when they have signings, and go get something signed. You don't need to be taking up space at a Major League Baseball game, an NFL game, an NBA game, you and your grown hairy man body getting autographs alongside 6 and 7 year old kids.
What if your main source of income is because you're a sports card trader and you need those autographs to make money?
Yeah.
Go get a real job.
Whoa.
Hey.
That is a real job.
That's legit.
They're called card breakers. Like they employ people to open packs and do live streams and stuff.
Well,
it's a real job. It's a real job.
You know what?
It's a way of making income. We talk about sports.
Go to Target, sign it, fill out an application, give it to the supervisor, and start on Monday.
You'd have a different outlook on this if you didn't have two daughters and you had two sons who were very much into sports cards or Pokemon cards, and they wanted them autographed up and wanted to...
Who gets Pokemon cards?
No, you get them autoed.
But who?
You know who's you know what's a lucrative industry?
Pikachu?
A mover. All right, go to your preferred moving company, fill out an application, and I bet you start in 48 hours. Okay? After a drug test. All right.
Background check.
You cannot tell me that you're gonna sit here. And I understand making some money off cards and things like that. I respect that. But you're going to go and your career, your money making is contingent upon you hip checking prepubescent kids out of the way in order to get signatures so you can sell them at a country club auditorium. You mean to tell me that seems good? Like, come on, guys. Maybe supplemental income, but come on.
Well, I would say, too, I wasn't even thinking about it for the guys that are looking to sell these things. There are some people past that age that still care about these athletes in a way to where they want autographed memorabilia to hang in their house. Similar to Shannon Sharpe, you know, there's guys our age and beyond.
That's even worse. That's even worse. Please sign my poster so I can put it in my room.
Technically, it is worse to us, but I try not to judge the things that fulfill others anymore. If you get happy off of a Tracy McGrady signed basketball, I'm not going to be the one to judge you. I'm happy for your joy.
Like, could you imagine? Hey, baby, I'm gonna go to the Dodgers game tonight. I've got this fresh new poster of Freddie Freeman. Oh. I think it would look great on our wall in the bedroom. Hey, Freddie, yeah. could you sign this poster? And then you walk in, you're like, baby, you're never going to believe it. Hang on to your panties. Put it up on the wall, Freddie Freeman signed poster. Most, come on, man.
But most men are going to put it in their man cave. And that's fine. Again, you clearly don't have a man cave.
Let me ask this.
You got a little...
Do any of you still own sports posters? If you're over the age of 25, do you still have sports posters hung in your residence. 888-760-3776. 888-760-3776. Social media at KLV1063. 888-760-3776. If you're over the age of 25, do you have a sports poster hanging in your residence? Stone, do you have a sports poster hanging in your residence? Because I would highly doubt Jess allows you to hang a sports poster.
It's in my man cave. And it's right behind my wall where
what's
my
your man
camera
cave?
Is.
What's your man cave?
We have a two. We got two bedrooms, two baths. There's two of us. So my man cave is where I record the other shows that I'm on. It's where some of the streaming goes down. And okay. I have a Stone Cold Steve Austin poster.
Is it a man corner or a cave?
It's a man corner. It's Stone Cold Steve. It's a really good question.
I was about to say.
Does it have one of those?
You the whole second barrel. Yeah. I was going to be very impressed.
And does it have one of those? I bet he uses one of those dividers on a roller that you like. put in the corner.
I have Michael Jordan golfing. I have Tiger Woods up there. I think that's about.
And how old are you now?
And I have Novak Djokovic.
You're 25?
25 years old.
By next year, that needs to go.
No, listen.
Grow
it's a man
up.
Corner.
It's for his backdrop.
It is my backdrop. Yeah. Like, legitimately my backdrop for the streaming and other recordings that I do. Thank you. It's not, I don't sit there and go, oh, yeah. It's the backdrop of my filming.
Grow up. Do you have sports posters, Theo? You're over 25.
I'm not allowed to.
See, that's what I'm saying, because he's grown.
Also, like...
he sounded pissed off that he wasn't allowed to.
So, here's what I'm mad about. I have that Dwayne Wade autographed jersey. Dwayne Wade is my favorite basketball player of all time. I earned this Dwayne Wade autographed jersey when we left the last office.
It's randomized.
We moved from our last studio.
You put in a raffle ticket. You didn't earn anything.
A raffle isn't earning?
No.
That's I earned it. I put all of my tickets in it, though.
Now,
so, like, I
if you
I
go to the Price is Right,
he competed harder because he put more tickets.
Yes,
if you go to the Price is Right and you spin the wheel and it lands on a dollar and you win $1,000, you didn't earn.
You earned
that.
It.
You got lucky.
You earned it. You spin the wheel.
Unless you
with the proper
you
amount
used
of torque.
Math to figure out the speed in which you needed to pull down the big gigantic beeping wheel. It doesn't work
that. We all got 10 raffle tickets. I put all 10 of my raffle tickets in the Dwayne Wade jar. Y'all spread y'all's out. You might have put one here, one there. I want the table. I want the TV.
You know what I didn't do? I didn't put any raffle tickets in. Want to know why? Because I didn't need the Dwayne Wade jersey because I'm grown.
It was just because you didn't want
touch.
It. You wanted the Tim Tebow or you wanted the Dan Marino.
You know you did.
In
no, I didn't put one in. I didn't put one in.
Neither did I. No jerseys for me.
Just posters. You're how mature.
Yeah, how did he try to just trivialize my jersey?
No, I was gonna say, hey, okay. Let me hold your jersey if your wife's not going to let you hang
it. It's somewhere in this office. My wife hasn't even let me take it home. So, yeah, you can grab it. I'm actually really heated about this because there's nowhere in my house I can hang it. And I want to be able to proudly display my Dwayne Wade jersey.
Get a man corner.
Get a man corner.
Get a man corner like Stone has.
It's legit just a corner of the bedroom where my desk and all my monitors are all set up and the backdrop. Thank you for calling it a backdrop because that's exactly why it was arranged.
It'll take
like
a lot of negotiating.
And
or
I got
a man corner.
Stone Cold, MJ, and Tiger up there.
If you're grown like me and don't need sports posters, perhaps you're getting of an age where you wake up and you're a little bit sleepier than normal. You can't get the day started without a billion cups of coffee. You don't feel like getting to the gym. You feel like you're struggling a little bit. You're cloudy. You're just not there. And people say, hey, man, you're just getting old. You're just getting old. There could be a fix for that, and that's where Elite Anti-Aging Center comes in. Elite Anti-Aging Center... First and foremost, if anything that I just said struck a chord with you, what you need to do is go to EliteTRT.com, EliteTRT.com, and get yourself a consultation. It can be in person. It can be teledoc. That's what's great. It's convenient for you. If you're up around 40 like I am and you're starting just not to feel like you've got the same energy, the same zest for life, then let me tell you, that it's Elite Anti-Aging Center, EliteTRT.com, EliteTRT.com, Elite Anti-Aging Center. They can help you. They've done it so many times before because it could be a sign of low testosterone, hormone imbalance. EliteTRT.com. Write it down. EliteTRT.com. That's Elite Anti-Aging Center. Devontae messages in. Ken's definitely giving off privilege. We never got to meet these people in our life. Of course, we're looking forward to getting something signed, especially if we couldn't afford it as a child.
Look at that. Look at that.
Am I coming off privileged?
I think you're coming off a little phony, actually.
Phony?
Yeah.
Phony for what? I just flat out said that I don't need sports posters. There's nothing phony about that. If I said, "Oh, I really wish I could have a Freddie Freeman poster," that would be me being phony.
You do come from a place of privilege because you get to meet all of these athletes and hang around them and cover them. I'm looking at C-Cat.
C-Cat, Christian Cat, Audible Assassin, do you want to weigh in on this real quick?
He doesn't want to weigh in, but I'm pointing the camera at somebody who brings a baseball glove to baseball games in hopes that he catches a ball.
That's actually trying to earn something. That's not shoving kids out of the way, presumably.
Yeah, no.
That would be earning something, not a raffle for a jersey.
He would shove a kid out of the way in a heartbeat.
Catching baseball is a sport.
Yeah.
That's a physical feat. Yeah. To catch a foul ball or home run ball, that's a physical feat.
Now, I do agree that him bringing a baseball glove to a game is earning it way more than putting in a raffle ticket to win a jersey.
Thank you.
How? How is that earning it? Because the ball fell in your glove?
It fell. All right, dude.
Yeah, the ball fell in your glove.
Someone's never caught a foul ball before.
It's so easy. No, yes, I can.
If you have a power hitter coming up and you know where he likes to hit, you got to line yourself up in left field if he's a right-handed hitter, man, if he's pulling it.
Catching a foul ball.
That's an
athletic feat.
Home run ball.
If we hit you 10 foul balls, I guarantee you're catching less than 50%.
All of them. Snagging them.
Less than 50%.
Come on. First of all, I got hands.
So wait. C-Cat. Do you have posters?
Sports poster. It was a gift from a friend.
Tiger Woods
poster. Haven't hung it up yet.
See, that's what I'm saying. Because he lives with his girlfriend. That's why he's grown.
Oh, Tiger Woods, though. You're allowed to put Tiger up.
I couldn't move over my high school football team picture. That's still hung up. So me and the 2014 state runner-ups, we're still on the wall.
You got any pictures of your band crew?
No.
Up in your man corner?
No, I have some yearbooks. Sometimes I'll sift through them and think about better days, and that's it. It gives me melancholy. Ricky says, you're very judgmental today. Am I being judgmental? I'm just saying grown men shouldn't need sports posters and shouldn't be at sports venues pushing little kids out of the way for said autographs. Go buy it. You're a grown person. Open up your wallet and go buy these autographs.
It doesn't even mean as much, though, if you just buy it. But if you get to meet an athlete,
shake their hand.
I'm not saying push a kid out of the way. But if you are a grown man and let's say, because I witnessed it. So I was when we were at the Roger Dean Chevrolet Stadium with Rick and Kill. There was a guy in there with a Rick and Kill jersey on. A Cardinals fan with a Rick and Kill jersey on. Grown man. I'm sure he had a well-paying job and a family and a really good life. He saw Rick and Kill, and he came up, and he got it signed.
Mm-hmm.
And that was one of the nicest moments. That guy's heart was fulfilled. He's a Rick and Kill and a Cardinals fan, and he got a Rick and Kill jersey signed, and he's going to be able to talk about that. Oh, my God.
Dave MacGyver Druda just brought in the Dwayne Wade jersey you earned via raffle.
Yes. ESPN West Palm Play on YouTube. You can check out my Dwayne Wade signed jersey. Let me scoot to the left a little bit so it shows. My Dwayne Wade signed
jersey.
Your wife needs to realize how happy you are right now.
I have so much joy. I'm filled with joy.
Oh, what I want you to do tonight, bring that home and ask her where you're, hey, baby, where would you like me to hang this?
Secretly
and tell us what she says.
Record it, and then, just like that, baby, where can I hang this?
That looks good. I mean, come on. Three-time champion.
Second
greatest shooting guard of all time.
Fine. I might come off as privileged or judgmental, but I promise you, after the age of 25, especially if you're living with somebody, you don't need sports posters, okay? And if you're going to get an autograph, go buy it, okay?
So what about the Rick and Kill fan that met Rick and Kill at a spring training game?
That's different.
Probably
He didn't push kids out of the way. He didn't push kids out of the way.
He stopped our radio broadcast.
In private, he said, Rick, can you sign this shirt? And how old was the guy?
He was probably like in his 50s. 40s, 50s.
All right. Oh, still, it wasn't like, hey, kid, get out of the way.
They would.
He wasn't leaning over the rail.
Stone, you were there. There were like 20.
And that's also because kids don't know who Rick and Kill is.
Well, that's not fair.
I'm talking about these kids now, Gen Z kids. That has nothing to do with Rick. That has everything to do with kids being like, Mookie Betts is the greatest of all time. Like, those kids, Shohei fans, don't have the respect for Rick that they should or that the older demographic does.
Tell you what, with the way that dude Shohei Ohtani just throws out cash on a whim, I'd be asking, forget an autograph, I'd be saying, hey, can I have $200?
Or at least some betting advice?
Want to sign a $100 bill for me?
Talk about privilege. This guy's just thinking about money, Theo. We just want true relations. We want to shake
love.
A hand. Yeah,
this is love right here. This is passion, man.
I'm sure Rick Ankiel has a great relationship now with the guy he signed his shirt at
they
Roger
have a
Dean
moment.
The other guy thinks they do.
They have a moment.
Nice little bond.
That guy's going to be talking about that for the next 20 years.
Yeah, God.
Or 30. I don't know.
Today, I've been called privileged. I've been called judgmental. And I've been canceled. This has been quite a day for me. I've hit the Holy Trinity, if you will. When we come back, we grade things. That's Theo. That's Stone. I'm Ken Levick at Theo and Stone, ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3. Now, let's check the Bradley Heating and Air Weather Center.
Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning, keeping the Palm Beaches cool since 1980. Visit them today at bradleyair.com.
Starting off our day with partly to mostly cloudy skies. Not too bad out there. It's pretty quiet, but a stray shower is possible anytime today. Along a windy southeast breeze, those winds blowing anywhere between 20 to 25 miles per hour, gusting up to 35 miles per hour. Now, that's especially along the coast. Temperatures this morning in the low 70s along the coast, 60s inland. Highs today in the low 80s. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on ESPN 106.3.
I'm Ellie Anajar of Anajar & Levine. Injured in a car crash? Never rush to settle with insurance companies and never settle for just any attorney. Demand Anajar & Levine. Our experienced legal team will fight to win you the maximum compensation you deserve. Call me, Ellie Anajar, for a free consultation and take back control of your life. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Hey, it's Josh Korn here to tell you about my friends at Truist Bank. Care is more than what's said. It's really about what's done. Whether it's helping you improve your financial well-being or supporting local small businesses, Truist inspires and builds better lives and communities by being there, listening, and making real connections. When you start with care, you get a different kind of bank. To learn more, visit Truist.com, T-R-U-I-S-T.com, or a Truist branch near you. Truist Bank, member FDIC.
What you drive says a lot about you. And if what you're driving has the Ed Morse name on it, it says you expect a lot from your vehicle and even more from the people you bought it from. You see, at Ed Morse, we don't just sell vehicles, we stand behind them. And behind each and every one of the more than 2 million people who drive them. That's why we've been in business since 1946 and why every person who drives off our lot is backed by Morse.
Ed Morse proudly supports the Miami Dolphins. Make sure your next vehicle is backed by Morse. Visit edmorse.com today.
Hey, it's Josh Korn here to tell you about my friends at Truist Bank. Care is more than what's said. It's really about what's done. Whether it's helping you improve your financial well-being or supporting local small businesses, Truist inspires and builds better lives and communities by being there, listening, and making real connections. When you start with care, you get a different kind of bank. To learn more, visit Truist.com, T-R-U-I-S-T.com, or a Truist branch near you. Truist Bank, member FDIC.
Hard Rock Bet presents Legal in Florida.
You can bet the game on Hard Rock Bet. No more betting inside your head.
Now Hard Rock Bet is legal in Florida. Now Hard Rock Bet is legal in Florida.
Legal in Florida.
It's safe, it's legal. We'll repeat that it is legal.
Top rated sportsbook and it's the only one that's legal.
Get a no-regret first bet up to $100 when you sign up now. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 and over and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMITTED.
When we made our McDonald's Spicy Chicken McNuggets, you were praise hands emoji. Then we ran out and you were streaming tears emoji. Now they're back, so you can be grinning face with sweat emoji. Order ahead on the McDonald's app.
Spicy Chicken McNuggets are back for a hot minute at McDonald's. Now get 25% off any purchase of $1 or more when you order ahead in the McDonald's app. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Offer valid through April 21st, 2024 at participating McDonald's. Valid once a day. Must opt into rewards. Excludes tax.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is, but the rest of your body, oh yes, it's gonna relish every moment of it. Because there are drinks. Then there are drinks from McDonald's.
Try any size frozen drink like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
This is Evan Cohen. Listen to Unsportsmanlike with me, along with Michelle Smallman and Chris Canty, weekdays at 6 a.m. here on ESPN 106.3.
From the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios, it's LaVica, Theo, and Stone, presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sportsbook on ESPN 106.3.
Bill says, Ken, you're being a jerk today. Sorry. I'm going through a lot. Okay? I'm going through a lot. My basketball coach just got introduced at Michigan. Yeah. Okay?
Did you hear his go blue?
No.
Oh,
did
man.
Did he say it?
Yeah, he did.
Can you get it?
I will grab it.
Oh, God.
That's always weird.
While Stone's doing that, Theo looks good. He looks clean. Thanks to the fine folks at Jay McLaughlin.
Yeah, man, it's funny because Jay McLaughlin, it was a place I had previously didn't think about walking into in the Palm Beach Gardens Mall, one of those stores I had walked past a few times. But then I had this event coming up where I was emceeing the Palm Beach County Sports Hall of Fame, and I wanted to make sure I was dapper, wanted to make sure I looked good in front of the fine folks as we inducted several of the biggest names that have inspired as well as impressed in Palm Beach County over the years in sports. So I checked out Jay McLaughlin. I walk in the store, and I thought it was going to be mostly women's store clothing in there because that was my perception of it beforehand, but they have a very vast men's selection right now. And again, this is a brand that's been around for nearly 50 years. It's a brand that not only has been around this long, but it is American, right? Two brothers, Kevin and Jay McLaughlin. They started this thing with an idea, right? They wanted to have clothes that were classic, yet traditional. There's somewhat of a preppy vibe. And Stone, do we have the photos I have from my Palm Beach County Sports Hall of Fame emceeing? We could throw up on ESPN West Palm Play here on YouTube.
It's sideways.
This one's sideways, but that shows you the coat that I got, right? It's a Lisbon linen blend blazer, right?
Lean sideways so you can see it properly.
I was about to say,
if you're at your desk, just tilt yourself to the left, and then you'll see it right side up.
But here's what I love about the blazer that I got here. It's a Lisbon linen blend blazer window pane, right? It's so breathable, Ken.
Mm-hmm.
And you know how hot it's getting outside these days. It's so breathable. It also, I was able to get this white linen-style dress shirt under it. Had the flared collar, how I like it. And it was a beautiful look. I did a little spin at the Palm Beach County Sports Hall of Fame. People came up to me afterwards, actually, and was like, where did you get your blazer? Where did you get your fit? I actually got the trousers I was wearing that night, too, from Jay McLaughlin. And I told them, Palm Beach Gardens Mall, it's on the second floor, and that store doesn't just have the finest selection of women's clothing. It also has some great menswear, and I didn't stop there. Not just for the Palm Beach County Sports Hall of Fame. I also got two more outfits for a couple upcoming events that I'm going to be emceeing and hosting. So if you want to look dapper, look clean, and also do it in style, some very, very elegant clothing, and the material definitely really good as well. Jay McLaughlin at the Palm Beach Gardens Mall, and check it out again. You see that window pane, Ken?
I see it.
You can pull that blazer off.
Yeah, it's a good-looking blazer. That's also a hell of a Mastacholi setup you got in front of you, dude.
Well, that was just, you know, a little grubbing at the Palm Beach Kennel Club.
Three cookies and a play ball. A mountain of Mastacholi.
When you look good, you eat well.
Big-ass cookies with a beautiful blazer.
That's
man.
Lisping. Linen blazer. So breathable. Jay McLaughlin, Palm Beach Gardens Mall. And stop hating on the food.
No,
all right?
I'm not hating on the
that
food.
That wasn't just
saying,
my cookies. It was Ashley, my wife Ashley.
You were hungry, man.
She also had a couple of those cookies.
You can't MC the Hall of Fame banquet on an empty stomach. In fact, it needs to be bloated.
It was like a chicken parm.
Uncomfortable.
Chicken parm was good.
Man, that is funny. Hey, real quick, you know what I need? I need one more time our indicator that it's a Hip Drop Tackle Tuesday here on LaVica, Theo, and Stone. Could I have that, Stone? Here's my question about the tackle. Where's the whistle? Like, that's a lot of tackling for a whistle not to happen. Like, wouldn't they stop play at that point?
Yeah, I mean, I told you officiating was hard.
Yeah, it's true. All right, that's banned, by the way. Not the sound effect, but the hip drop tackle. All
swivel
right.
Hip drop.
Right. Swivel. I'm sorry. Swivel hip sorry. Drop. Swivel. Let's grade things here on the Vic at Theo and Stone. Grading things. I give you a topic. We grade it like we're teachers in school with a letter grade. A, B, C, D, F. Very simple concept. And took me about 6 seconds to come up with it about 4 months ago. It is time now for the Vic at Theo and Stone grade things here on ESPN 106.3. Boys, here is the opening topic. The opening topic that we are going to grade, and that is the brand new NFL kickoff rules. Brand new NFL kickoff rules. Now, before we grade it, let me go through what the brand new kickoff proposal is in the NFL and what the rules are and how this is going to proceed, okay? Are you guys familiar with the XFL kickoff?
Yes, sir.
It's basically that. If you're not aware, here we go. The kicking team, the 10 players cannot move until the ball hits the ground or the player in the landing zone or the end zone. Receiving team, all players in the setup zone cannot move until the kick has hit the ground or a player in the landing zone or the end zone. Any kick that hits in the landing zone, that's goal line to 20-yard line, must be returned. Any kick that hits before the landing zone, touch back to the 40, as if it went out of bounds. If the kick hits the landing zone, rolls into the end zone, and is down, that's a touch back to the 20. If the kick lands in the end zone or goes out of the back, touch back to the 35. Onside kick. Fourth quarter begins. The team trailing has the opportunity to declare an onside kick to the officials. Current onside kickoff rules would apply. No fair catch or signal is allowed, and the proposal is for 1 year only. That looks like that's where we're going with the NFL. Can you guys follow all that? Did you follow all that? Here's what I'll take from this. It's an A. It's an A. It's an A for me because it brings the kickoff return back into the sport of football, instead of a touchback every single time. And in fact, it almost penalizes you for striving for a touchback because the offensive team gets, no matter the case, a fantastic bit of field position. But good Lord, man, the NFL, professional football, has so many damn rules.
Yeah.
This further maintains for me, further reinforces what I've always said about American football. If there was an alien species that came from a galaxy 4 billion light years away, okay? And they come and they don't have adversarial designs. They want to become friends with our race.
Nice.
And we sit down with them and say, hey, let's teach them our sports. We could go through baseball. We could go through basketball. We could go through cricket. We could go through rugby. We could go through paddleball, highlight, any sport we try and teach them. An alien race would be confused more by professional football and all the rules than any other sport on this planet. Mm. There are more rules in professional football than any sport that is played on this planet. It's ridiculous, and this is just another indicator of that.
Just give them like 2.5 minutes in a room with RG3, and he'll get them right through to the
hip-hop
point.
On top, yeah. Molly Womp. So yes. I give it an A, but God, it's going to take a while to decipher all that once we actually start. It's why nobody remembered the playoff overtime rule in the Super Bowl, including the 49ers, because there's so many damn rules.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and grade it, Theo.
Well, the Chiefs knew the rules, by the way.
It's true.
I got to go A-plus on this one because it brings back maybe the most electric play in all of football, and that's a kick return for a touchdown. I'll never forget when Devin Hester did it in the opening on the opening kickoff of the Super Bowl, Bears Colts back then, and I thought the Bears were going to run away with the thing. Think about guys like Dante Hall. You think about guys like Pac-Man Jones. Like, if we're able to see that next wave of guys take over games with kick returns and punt returns, like I'm all in for it. I can't wait.
So I give it an A. Theo gives it an A+. New NFL kickoff rules. The Vic and Theo and Stone grade thing. Stone, where are you at on the new kickoff rules?
You guys.
It's safer. And it brings kickoffs back into the sport, which I think is wildly important in a year where Devin Hester got inducted into the Hall of Fame a couple years too late, in my opinion. LaVig at Theo and Stone grade things here on ESPN 106.3. Let's grade keeping tabs on the Travis Kelce-Taylor Swift relationship in the offseason. I saw today that they're in the Bahamas and they're heavy petting. And they're kissing, and they're romantic. They were at Nobu in Malibu having lunch a couple of days ago. Boy, are they jet-setting those two. I give this whole thing a D. I right now, I'm not in Travis Kelce, Taylor Swift mode. I don't care. Let the kids live their lives, okay? I give it a D. I don't need to keep tabs on it right now until they break up.
Yeah.
Or it's football season.
I'll go F. I'm even more of a stringent grader. I don't want to see any of this stuff because as a Chiefs fan, it was only cool and fun as we were winning games. Right now, I really don't care. So F.
Okay. Stone, grade it. Grade Taylor Swift, Travis Kelce, keep in terms of their relationship now in March.
Let's go B plus.
Fun. So you're still into it.
Yeah, I'm definitely still into it. Fun for the whole family. I'm an avid.
Okay.
The whole family.
I'm an avid entertainer.
Come here, kid. Sit on. Let me show you the tongue action that Travis Kelce and Taylor Swift are performing on the beach.
And I followed Entertainment Tonight on all social media platforms, and they keep me in the loop with all this stuff. And also, I can't remember the last time I saw Taylor Swift in a bikini. So, you know, give me the updates that I'm looking for.
Speaking of Entertainment Tonight, did you know I tried to book Kevin Frazier before the Super Bowl for this show?
What?
And guess what? I got ghosted.
Really?
Yeah, Kevin Frazier ghosted me. So I'd suggest you go access Hollywood. We're boycotting. We're banning Entertainment Tonight.
Entertainment Tonight is a great group.
Well, tell Kevin Frazier then to get the hell on the show.
B plus for T Swift and Trav.
We could have used him.
Also, Travis Kelce, shave your chest. I mean,
why? Why?
More aerodynamic.
Definitely my thought process there. And his, I didn't know he had a gut the way he had a gut. So glad I could see that kind of stuff because I never really know.
You of all, like, you're going to judge Travis Kelce for having a gut?
Yeah.
Let that man live in his offseason, dude. Patrick Mahomes has a gut, as we saw, and he won a damn Super Bowl.
Three of them.
Stone.
Right. There's that.
Men, keep your chest hair.
Yeah.
Great stuff here. LaVica, Theo, and Stone on ESPN 106.3. Out of state drivers. Let me explain. Anytime I get caught off, anytime anybody's going too slow, anytime someone's on my rear end in traffic, I always get disproportionately more mad when I see that they're an out-of-state driver. Primarily New York license plate, primarily Ontario license plate, primarily Quebec license plate. Really anywhere in the Northeast, I get more mad when it's an out-of-state driver than I do with someone that has a Florida license plate. Out-of-state drivers, I give them an F. I don't know what angers me more, but I will say they make me more angry when they commit traffic violations in my vicinity. How do you grade, Theo?
I say B, because Florida drivers aren't much better.
But at least they're us. They're one of us. You can be a little bit more forgiving.
See, I don't feel like I'm one of us yet.
It's You've like, been hey, in Florida New Hampshire, we're on 95. Speed the hell up.
Yeah.
This ain't Montpelier. Is that Vermont? Is that Vermont? Is Montpelier Vermont or is it New Hampshire? Damn it.
Yeah, you're cooked.
I think it's
Vermont. You also could have just stuck with it. We would have never questioned you.
I know.
That's
but someone would have. Yeah. No way. I've been canceled all day today.
You have been getting killed.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't, you know, drivers from Florida, Texas, you know, Virginia, North Dakota, it doesn't matter to me. Yeah. Get out of my way.
Okay. Stone, grade out-of-state drivers.
F minus. I mean, they're the biggest.
Hindrance,
nuisance.
Yeah. Go home.
I mean, they're the worst people on planet Earth.
Go home.
Am I an out-of-state driver?
No, you have a Florida license plate.
That might be the problem.
Don't you? You have a Florida license plate.
I think I do now.
I meant to say Manchester, New Hampshire. This ain't Manchester, New Hampshire. You can't go 60 on 95. Okay?
All right.
You can't go 60 on 95. You can't take that right turn off the main road at 4 miles an hour. Like there are people, I mean, F minus.
And I'm telling you, if you're in the fast lane, time to speed it up. All right? We ain't got time to go 62 in the far left lane.
No.
Okay? This is I-95.
Come on.
The Rod of Champions.
Get out of here.
And that's great stuff here on LaVica, Theo, and Stone. That's Theo, that's Stone. I'm Ken. LaVica, Theo, and Stone, ESPN 106.3.
Hey guys, it's Josh Cohen. When I want to watch the UFC, Twin Peaks is my local headquarters. With wall-to-wall 4K HD TV, you're there for every knockout. Never a cover charge to watch any of the fights. And once you step inside the lodge, you're surrounded by Twin Peaks girls, serving up made-from-scratch food and the signature 29-degree cold beer. Catch every main event at your UFC headquarters, Twin Peaks. Located right off I-95 and Palm Beach Lakes Boulevard, Twin Peaks. Eats, drinks, and scenic views.
Is your credit on life support? Greenway Key of West Palm Beach will be hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Local bank representatives will be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you have a job bringing home $350 weekly, the credit clinic at Greenway Key of West Palm Beach wants to approve you so you can drive home your new Kia today. Greenway Key of West Palm Beach will be hosting a credit clinic at the dealership. I repeat, Greenway Key of West Palm Beach will be hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 weekly, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia today. So what are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS or go online at greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval term.
The MVPs of sports and science are teaming up. Join Marlins legend Jeff Conine and Dolphins great Nat Moore, along with the top doctors from Sylvester Comprehensive Cancer Center, for breakfast on March 27th in Boca Raton. The Men for PAP conference will tackle the subject of men's health and cancer prevention in a fun and informative way, with a conversation led by ESPN West Palm's own Theo Dorsey. Get your tickets today at thepapcorps.org. That's PAPCORPS.org.
Hey, it's Dean Thomas. If you are serious about a career in golf, check out the College of Golf at Keiser University. Enroll in Keiser's Golf Management Program and get your degree from the best in the business. Three PGA Master Professionals and an LPGA Hall of Famer on staff. You can earn your degree on campus or online in just 16 months. Scholarships and financial aid are available. Take your swing at a rewarding career in golf at Keiser University. More info at collegeofgolf.keiseruniversity.edu.
Hey, Steph Prince here, General Manager of ESPN West Palm, to tell you about a team that has meant a lot to me and this community for a long time. Bob and the team at Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning have been helping me stay cool for years, whether at home or in the office. And living in South Florida with three kids, I don't know what I'd do without them. Family owned and operated, serving Royal Palm Beach and beyond since 1980. Let the knowledgeable and trained team at Bradley help you with your residential and commercial needs. Installation, repair, seasonal maintenance, upgrades of all makes and styles and models of HVAC equipment, and so much more. Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning does things right the first time and makes the process smooth, stress-free, and most importantly, keeps you cool. Give them a call at 561-793-7497. That's 561-793-7497 or bradleyair.com. Any need, big or small? Trust the amazing team at Bradley Heating and Air Conditioning.
Whether it's a clutch touchdown pass, a game-winning dunk, or a dash to the finish, we want to highlight the best performance of the week presented by Baptist Health South Florida. Every week, different teams will be highlighted across ESPN 106.3 and ESPN West Palm Play. The winning performance receives $500 courtesy of Baptist Health South Florida. Know of a team, player, or school with a killer performance? Nominate them today by emailing highschool@espnwestpalm.com. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care. Go where the pros go.
Hey guys, it's Josh Cohen from the home team. South Florida is buzzing with good vibes thanks to Celsius. Whether I'm hosting the show, attending an event, or outside relaxing by the pool, Celsius keeps me refreshed with 7 essential vitamins and new mouth-watering flavors like green apple cherry, oasis vibe, and lemon lime. You'll be refreshed enough to enjoy the good vibes. Purchase your favorite flavors today at your local retailers. Celsius Essential Energy Drinks.
From the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios, it's LaVica, Theo, and Stone. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book on ESPN 106.3.
Reminder, tomorrow a listening lunch here on LaVica, Theo, and Stone. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care, they have a team of skilled orthopedic sports medicine surgeons and specialists that specialize in surgical and non-surgical treatments to get you back to what you love. Don't put off seeing a doctor. Visit baptisthealth.net/ortho today for more information. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care combines its resources of experienced physicians, leading-edge treatments, and technology to provide advanced orthopedic foot and ankle, joint replacement, spine, and sports medicine care. Visit baptisthealth.net/ortho for more information today. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care has offices conveniently located in Palm Beach County through the Florida Keys. Learn more by visiting baptisthealth.net/ortho. Can I leave you with some good news here, Theo?
Need it. Need it.
I'm not usually a big proponent of Wednesday football. Let's do it Thursday, Sunday, Monday, sometimes Saturdays. Even that's a little bit too much for my senses. But get this. The NFL is going to play football Christmas Wednesday, December 25th. That sets up the following. December 25th, NFL game. December 26th, NFL game. December 28th, NFL games. December 29th, NFL game. December 30th, NFL game. Wow. December 31st, quarterfinals, college football playoff. January 1st, quarterfinals, college football playoff. Ooh. I can make an exception here. That's some hot, heavy football action.
I can't wait. I can't wait.
An avalanche of football, if you will.
Kicking it with family, watching football. Watching the pigskin.
Tomorrow we find out if Theo's allowed to hang Dwayne Wade's jersey in his home. And adults, stop putting sports posters up in your house. That's Theo. That's Stone. I'm Ken. Talk to you tomorrow. Bye. Bye.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen. Are you or a loved one experiencing memory loss, misplacing your keys, or forgetting people's names? Memory diseases affect